Shall we load the game or should it's loading? It's
totally.
loading. Okay, let's go. Game one. Top Spin versus Hiten. Hey Nitin, what's up? Welcome, welcome to stream. So, are you in game?
Yeah, I'm in game.
So yeah, so you quickly introduce Hiten and I'll go for Top Spin.
So Hiten is a player from Indus Clan, a very old Indian clan. He used to play very actively on Wubbly. Now he is staying in Portugal. He's finishing his PhD there. And he plays on a high level, like 16xx plus DE level. And the same is Top Spin. Top Spin is his clanmate from Wubbly. He was one of the best players of Wubbly that India had, like top four players. And he's very, very strong and aggressive player.
Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, both the players are very old to the game, and also they're pretty good at the. Oh shit! Hiten just lost the villager to the
Yeah,
to the
and
rhino.
he knows that he's versus Top Spin, who is famous for laming.
Oh yeah,
So
makes
he's
sense why.
already trying to take his rhinos.
Oh yeah, if you guys don't know, Topspin is our like sort of Indian MBL. He sort of lames almost all the games. Whenever he finds a chance to lane, he'll just go for it. So keeping that in mind, Hiten try to get his boar faster. And yeah, seems like he lost one villager to the rhino. That's pretty bad and pretty bad start for him.
And interestingly, both of them have picked Vikings, which is a Lizo counter. So I think Hiten was expecting Top Spin to pick Mayans or Aspects.
So what do you
And
think of these maps? Like for Vikings, it's usually you usually go for men-at-arms to archers. But looking at the maps, some people even directly go for double archery range. So based on this map, what do you think?
I think Manhattan's opening would be better.
And
You
like.
just force the enemy to be in his base for longer, and you just get the initiative.
True. And looking at Topspin's map, like what do you suggest? Like go for double archery range directly, or maybe throw some men-at-arms in the beginning and then get some like in a good eco up and running, and then go for a double archery range.
I think they should both go for man-at-arms because you can see that their maps are not like fully vulnerable, like very exposed areas. Top Spin's map on the left side is super exposed.
Yeah, true.
Maybe he can close the right side with some buildings and walls, but the left side is so hard.
True. So, and
And
also, yeah.
Hiten's map on the top side is also exposed.
His main gold and stone is outwards, and also his secondary gold is also sort of exposed.
Yeah, both there. Actually, if you see that all their extra golds are towards the center, only Hiten has like one gold on the right side.
Yeah. Pretty weird map for
There
both the
are yeah,
players.
there are many golds in the center, so
And also
I
look at
can
the
see
hills in
three.
the center. There are a lot of hills in the center.
Yeah, usually there are like hills like that in Arabia, and that's why you need to go aggressive and take control of those hills.
Yeah, true. So we might see some very aggressive play between these two players. We both go for men-at-arms and then two archers. But looks like already Hiten is trying to sort of wall off his base to secure that main gold. And Topspin, yeah, both the players are not walling, it's just too early to wall. So, these hills in the middle, they play, I mean, very important role to win the game, especially if the game goes late. So, looking at Hiten's base, there's one hill right in front of his main stone and his that extra gold pile. Castle on that hill would be pretty good. And for Topspin and the castle on his forward gold would be also pretty good. That would actually secure at least one gold pile among those two. Oh, we can see. Okay. Then just
So
go.
some
Sorry?
No, I was just pointing out the scouts.
I see. So Topspin already going for barracks. Okay, both the players going for barracks at the same time. It looks
yeah,
like
and Topspin is actually up.
Ah, he's actually up faster than.
It's quite like 21 pops is quite fast.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And he's already securing that main gold, like you said, he's gonna stone, palisade wall that area. And yeah,
yeah,
he's
actually
going...
that's very good wall for top.
Mm-hmm. So he's gonna go for, but like still no militia queued up the barracks.
Yeah, Topspin went up too fast, I think.
That's gonna hurt him to get those militia out. He then already queued up 3 minute arms, okay, we can also...
Or maybe Topspin is thinking of not making militia, I think.
Oh, that's...
Yeah.
Okay.
He's not trying to make militia.
Oh, that's actually pretty bold move by him.
I think because he's up that fast, he won't be able to afford minute arms and also keep producing villagers. So I think he's just choosing for a bit more defensive approach with straight archers.
So, I mean, with just one... lumber camp and only few villages chopping trees. Do you think he can go for like double terrain? I don't think so.
Yeah, well, he can add the first range, make some archers. He has to fix his info.
But at least
he's quite fast, so it's hard to afford everything.
Yeah,
it's
true. But at least he has secured that gold. But yeah, many times are already here. Oh, this is gonna be pretty bad.
And Topspin is going to lose the scout maybe.
Oh, that scout is almost dead. It's good for nothing now.
But he needs to make walls fast. Oh, actually,
yeah,
he
nice
might fail
walls.
Here. The man-at-arms get in.
Oh,
it'd
man.
This is
pretty bad for him. A lot
oh,
of items. Oh,
yeah,
the
yeah.
Scout's gone down for both the players. See how Hiten's micro is gonna be here. It's a lot of idle time.
Yeah, Hiten already has a huge advantage now. Like his man-at-arms are doing damage.
Mm. So he already killed
and like
one
keeping
village.
Four villagers idle, killing one villager.
Yeah.
And another. Oh no, he saves that.
Almost. Oh, but he's sending
but
that villager back. Okay.
He's getting a lot of idle time and like Topspin's eco is a total mess.
Yes.
He's not able to afford secondary. Lumber camp or secondary archery.
But he is sort of trying to make some archers. He has a couple of archers.
Yeah, those two archers will kill the Manatam, but they have bought enough time.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I mean, he's gonna be alright for now. But looking at Hithane's space, okay, he's going for an archery range just now. And the will difference is not so much now.
It's just three villages.
Three villager
three
difference.
Villages.
But it's
and
actually
considering
good for...
that Hiten already lost one villager.
Mm-hmm, yeah, to the rhino. That's bad.
And also Hiten has gone for the eco approach. Like he got all his eco upgrades, taking farms.
Yeah.
Only has 3 on gold, so he's taking some storms first.
Mm.
Because he knows that he will be behind in archer numbers.
Yeah,
so
true. And,
some
and also he knows that Topspin might come to his base with those archers. So yeah, a couple of skirms is really good idea. And also
and
look at the wall.
Wall the
yeah, that's actually a good wall. He can secure that wood line at the back of his town center.
I don't know why he left that big hole between the house and the forest.
Where? Is there a hole? Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's fully open there.
Probably to trap. Is he gonna trap?
Maybe he just forgot about that.
Yeah, makes sense.
How the archers will...
Yeah, those archers are not gonna do any sort of damage right now.
Yeah, they don't have fetching. Topspin is still on one archery. Now he's. Actually, Topspin is going for stable.
What? He forget that he's playing Vikings? Maybe he thinks that he's playing it as Huns.
Going for some feudal aggression, but he doesn't know that Hiten is not actually doing some just comms, he's doing archers as well.
Yeah, true. Yeah. So, I mean, soon he's gonna get fletching too. He's dropping blacksmiths right now. But on the other side, Topspin is still trying to wall off his base. But, like, do you think scouts are gonna do some sort of damage here?
No.
He's just, like, wasting a lot of resources. He could have actually gone for a blacksmith or maybe another archery range.
Maybe he thinks that Hiten will do some mass skirmishers or something. But Hiten is not doing it. He just added one scum. For some defense.
Mm-hmm. So still no fletching for both the players. Looking at the economy, Hiten's still ahead by 3 wills, and Topspin is probably trying to go up with the villager numbers and maybe. Oh, okay. This is really bad position. So Hiten just sent his army back. Now Topspin is moving forward with his archers, and still no fetching for both the players. Okay, he's gonna bring back his army now.
Oh, but he's not going to the gold. He should have gone to the gold
Yeah,
there.
exactly. He would have easily killed at least one or two wills there.
Yeah, and the important thing is to keep his archer numbers low. If you are going the scout strategy, you don't want him to make archers. You want to pressure him off his gold. And if he manages to do that, then Kane will be out of gold. Then you can
So
push.
this is pretty good by Hiten. So he sort of
Yeah, nice
expected those
picking points for him.
archers gonna come back to the wood line. And he's just patrolling that area with his skirms and archers. Okay, fletching now coming
I
for
think
both players.
Topspin thought that he would not have the fletching and Hiten would have it, so he just
Yeah, true.
didn't want to dive in.
Oh, this is gonna be interesting. Now scouts and archers together. But scouts are gonna get wrecked now.
Scouts, they don't do much versus fletching archers.
Yeah, true. And yeah, this is really good walling by Hiten. So he's gonna secure that
And
lumber
Topspin
camp.
is going to run like Lucio or not?
Oh boy. Yeah, if he wants to enter that wood line, he definitely has to go through the TC. So right now, Hiten is just defending his base and also a defensive watchtower. What do you think of that watchtower? Is it good?
Yeah, I think because he knows that Topspin is making a lot of army.
Oh boy. So actually, okay. If Topspin focuses on the villages, he can actually get one or two before he loses his army. The
Yeah.
watchtower fire. Oh,
But
he
actually,
didn't
nice, very
even.
nice work by Hiten. He didn't kill
Yeah.
a single villager.
That's true. Pretty good micro by Hiten. Amazing.
Maybe he lost the archer numbers, but it was a good trade. Now his base is secure. His wood lines are walled
Yeah.
towards the TC, and he has tower on the gold. Now he will just try to go up. Actually, Topspin can also go up. Topspin has had idle TC for a long time.
Yeah, and Hiten just clicked up to Castle A, so he'll be reaching
Yeah,
to
and
Castle
six
faster.
villagers ahead.
Oh, and that's gonna
Six
be a
villagers
lot.
ahead.
Yeah, 43 wills for Hiten and just 37 for Topspin. And
And he's
Topspin.
already up, and Topspin needs to buy
Oh
up.
my. He just clicked up. So both the players are using market to do some sort of abuse. And the triple archery range for Hiten and Topspin still at 2 archery ranges. Oh man, this is gonna be pretty bad for Topspin if Hiten masses enough number of crossbows.
Yeah.
Like investing into that stable, I think is not a good idea.
Yeah, that stable was pretty bad.
Yeah, it did nothing for him. Like those scouts got wrecked. Four scouts. They didn't even kill a single villager. And also losing his that initial army, at least some like 5 to 10 archers to the skirms and few archers of Hiten, and also to the watchtower. It's not good. So kill death ratio 15 to Topspin and 10 to Hiten. Hiten is doing pretty good here. Economically, he's ahead, and Topspin is behind by wills. So, okay. This military is gonna get wrecked too. So, military-wise, 21 military for Topspin. So he, I mean, imagine if now Topspin gets into his base. Okay, the town center. So what do you think of this play, Mothi? It's
Yeah,
pretty defensive
nice.
play by
Yeah.
Hiten. And also a crossbow coming in time.
I would have liked that Hiten should have tried to take a fight to do the archers.
What, sorry?
Using the facility upgrade, he should have tried to initiate a fight. He might get a good fight now. Topspin is not waiting for the upgrade.
Oh, now Topspin.
But he has a lot of skirms in his
Yeah,
base.
he has skirms, but still no bodkin for him. What? Okay, Topspin just went for elite skirms.
Actually,
That's
Hiten
a.
also doesn't have.
Green.
Oh boy. So yeah.
Tekken also doesn't have bot
Huh?
kill.
Yeah, both the players doesn't have bot gun. Topspin is just
So
continuously
Topspin
making
has bot kill.
scums.
Tekken forgot bot kill, I think.
Looks like so.
I don't know why Hiten has not that much numbers. He has 3 archer ranges. I hope he remembers bot kill.
Topspin is desperately trying to get into his wood line so that he can at least get two kills there. But Hiten looks like he is not worried about that palisade wall there. And he's dropping okay, university, so that's gonna be ballistics for Hiten. And Topspin back home, okay, he's going for three town centers. And look at the will lead now. Hiten is leading by eight
Yeah,
wills already.
8 villages.
Okay, this wood line, let's see if okay, oh, one down. Okay, that's actually
Beginning is
good
doing a
reaction
smart thing
time.
by counter-attacking now.
And also at the wood line, it's a good reaction time by Hiten, so he sort of lost only one villager where he could have lost like two to three easily. Now he's going for counter.
That TC might go up, but it's not really defending the gold. He might push him out of it.
Oh yeah.
But he is just gonna break the single layer barrier.
And there is no Siege Workshop for Topspins. Like these archers can do a lot of damage if they can actually get into his base. Topspin's
And the
army is out
storms
of
now, he
place.
is also doing elite storms without bot kill still, but he's getting the ballistics.
Yeah, ballistics would actually do a lot of damage if he can
And
actually.
Topspin is even doing the +2 armor.
Boy. Yeah, this is again good defense by Topspin, so he has
Yeah,
some numbers
Topspin is
back.
going to defend that.
Yeah. That'd be pretty easy, he has a lot
Let's see
of
the micro with
scums.
ballistics. Maybe with
Yes.
ballistics he can take. But he's still missing bot kill arrows, so you should realize it.
Both the players doesn't have it. Seems like
No, Topspin has bot
Topspin.
kill
Oh
now.
yeah, Topspin has bot kill now.
Tekken just
And
forgot about it.
Topspin is getting ballistics faster than Hiten, or Hiten already got ballistics too, right?
Yeah, he already got ballistics.
Oh, he's gonna lose a lot of numbers here.
Oh, those archers
Oh, he
might
got
get
trapped.
damaged.
That's good map presence by Topspin, but
Yeah, but
back
without
home.
ballistics, ballistics is just a little too late. A little bit too late. He could have got half of those also.
But look at the army composition for both the players. Almost similar number of skirms and archers for both the players.
Only thing is the will difference.
So will difference is
Now Topspin
still
going aggressive
yeah,
with
full aggressive.
Siege Workshop.
Yeah, Hiten is just going for full economy and like defensive. And Topspin not sending his army to the right place. Hiten is well defended back home. He doesn't have to worry about his base. He can actually go for counter. Okay, there you go. He's sort of waiting for a mangonel, looks like. Oh, what do you think of that siege workshop, Moti? Like on the hill? That would have been amazing castle position.
Yeah, but it also make your siege workshops on such a
And also he's adding few
try to get the
knights.
mangonel hill bonus.
Oh, okay, I see. Still, yeah, these archers at
With
Hiten's
that
base are
plus
not
two
really
armor, you
good.
can just run under the TC even with the scouts.
It
Just
looks like
kill
he's not
as
gonna
many
do
villagers as you
that.
can and defend with mangonel. I think if you take like a 6-7 villagers here, then Topspin, you can just go underneath the tower even. Like that tower won't do much
Yeah.
versus
So,
teammates.
yeah, right now
And
Topspin is just trying to go back home and
yeah,
regroup
he
with his
shouldn't go back
army.
right now. I think if he went inside, like just try to kill as many villagers, just
Yeah,
create a mess.
like any wood line, he could have got like at least 3 to 4 kills,
Yeah,
even
send
more than
some two
that.
archers on the back of that wood line for him.
The Topspin is
But I think looking at the score, he maybe thinks that he's ahead in the info
economy.
department,
Yeah,
so
true.
he's trying to be a bit safer. Topspin is also looking to pick up soon.
Oh,
He
while
doesn't have the
Mangonels are
second
moving
villager.
forward. Oh, no, this is pretty bad. Okay, but
Topspin is
still
up. Topspin is up.
up to Imperial. And looking at the army, both the players are at the
Oh, the
similar
mangonels
number.
might. That mangonel might die from Topspin, and he can see the.
It
Oh,
already.
he didn't even get any damage.
Yeah, that's pretty good micro by Hiten. Somehow he sort of managed to not to lose that army completely.
Now Topspin should just play a bit defensive since he's up.
Looking at the score, Hiten should know by now that.
But Hiten will make a castle down. Soon. Hiten, I don't know where he wants to make the castle. He should make it forward.
Oh, this is pretty good castle too.
Yeah, that's a good castle.
Yeah, right in front of the goal, it's gonna secure the goal.
I think Topspin's Imperial won't be in time to get any advantage.
Mati, can you speed up maybe a couple of seconds? So I'm at.
No, I'm at the same time as this.
I'm at 34 minutes.
Yeah, you? I don't see the
game. I'm at 34:10.
Yeah, I'm almost there.
Okay. I'll pause for a second and then I'll pause. So,
I'm 34:20 now. 34:30.
Oh, okay, cool. Let's go.
Yeah, so now Topspin position won't make much difference, and he's 15-16 villages behind.
Yeah, he's gonna be behind with the villager count for the rest of the game, looks like. But I mean, this castle, look at that castle, that's gonna give Hiten a lot of map control. And he's gonna be pretty happy to not to see a castle by Topspin right on the top of the hill. If Topspin would have placed a castle on that hill, it would have given him a lot more advantage, I think.
Topspin is higher rated than Kane.
Yeah.
But I see some people in the chat asking.
I see.
But like, he's Imperial, but he doesn't have castle of his own. Military numbers are looking quite even, but with that Imperial, he doesn't get any advantage.
Now Topspin is trying to go around.
Trying to go around and something.
Do you think really that's gonna be worthy for Topspin? He may get few wells, but he cannot push right. He needs his siege.
Now, even if he kills villagers there, Hiten is still already ahead, and Hiten will push with trebuchets.
Exactly.
And Topspin doesn't have defenses at home now, so he. Mm-hmm. He will take much more damage than Hiten.
Yeah. So, with this strategy, I think Topspin is gonna be in a pretty bad situation.
They both are very good friends and from the same clan for.
Afer. Yeah, they are. Yeah. So, I mean, right now. It looks like Hiten has got really good position, so he's in good control of his game, and Topspin's army is sort of all over the map, not just all over, it's just at Hiten's space, and he's not being able to do any sort of damage, and all these mangonels, I think they're just not gonna be good, because there is a castle, and if they go close to the castle, they get wrecked. What do you think of this play now? Why is Topspin so passive?
I think like his start wasn't the best, the Maritime did some damage. And now he knows that he's behind an eco, he can see the score.
Yeah, and 80 to 90.
It's very hard to play in such positions.
Yeah. And also trebuchets are faster for Hiten, and this Topspin's castle is gonna go down pretty soon too.
Yeah.
He's making He doesn't have stone. Okay, he just bought some to repair the castle. Oh boy.
Topspin is not even making trebuchets.
And he is going for stable. Like four stables. What?
Yeah, that's quite bad.
Yeah, it's pretty bad move. So looks like he wants to just snipe those trebuchets so that he can save the castle. But, I mean.
Yeah.
I'm not sure of his decision right now. Oh boy. So more trebuchets coming out for Hiten, and Topspin still with those mangonels, and his army is out of place. He's trying to raid Hiten on top, but that's not gonna work out there. A lot of skirms on the other side. He's gonna be pretty fine in that area too. Even if those archers move in, they're gonna get wrecked to those curves. And now Hiten is going for a counter raid. So he's just sneaking in those Arbalas the other side. Oh, it's just gonna explode, looks like. So that castle is going down. This looks like GG to me.
Yeah, where are Hiten's arbalist?
Oh boy. This is GG.
Looks like GG.
Yeah, Topspin, he's not doing anything with those light cavalry. Okay, he's moving forward now. Let's see if he's gonna kill at least one trebuchet. Nope, not yet. And now look at the military difference, 67 to 53, and villages 97 to 87. There's still that 80 will leave. And losing all this light cavalry, he's gonna lose all the skirms to the castle. Oh boy, this is pretty bad. This is GG. Oh no. So that's actually good micro there by both the players, but still Topspin doesn't have enough members to do anything. And also he doesn't have his own castle, so there you go, he calls GG.
Wilding, my game is crashing, I need to restart.
Okay, I'll wait. Look at this guys, outpost rushing by Hiten. So let's see what Topspin can see. Okay, right now we cannot see. it's all visible. But yeah, there are outposts all over on the side of the map. And right side, he just scouted this complete area with the Arbalest. And he came back to the castle. Pretty good defense by Hiten. And I think Topspin sort of got nice, little sloppy there. And four stables is a bad idea, and it didn't work out very well for him. So good game. So let's have a quick look at the stats. 102 wills for Hiten, and look at those timings. Topspin reached feudal faster, but still he did not do any damage. He wasn't able to make men-at-arms. He was defending against Hiten's men-at-arms, and he lost one villager to that men-at-arms rush. But other than that, he had good control till late castle. But once Hiten dropped that forward castle, then yeah, game was pretty much by then. But well played. Military counts almost a similar number of military, but that Topspin lost 60 units. Oh, bad. It's a good game. Well played. So the scores 1-0. Let's see if Topspin gonna sort of back into the game. Yes, are you guys seeing any sort of frame drops? I see once in a while, but not that much.
User joined your channel.
Oh, not much. Oh, thank you. Pretty decent today. I'm in Bangalore Hiten now. So I don't have to worry about those continuous frame drops like, you know, every second. This is much better. So, Motsi, you here?
Yeah.
Shall we
I'm just launching the game now.
Okay, just a second.
You can start. I'll speed up. You start.
So this is game 2 guys, between Topspin versus Hiten, and this is African Waters, right?
No. This is not game 2, this is game 3.
Which one? African Waters, right?
Yeah, sure. African Waters is supposed to be game 3.
Oh shit, I loaded the wrong game then.
I think he numbered them wrong, so we'll okay. Just open game 3.
So just a second guys. Titanic. no worries, Hiten. So I'm gonna load game number 2. Oh, what map is this? Oh, Acropolis. Oh, nice. So this is Topspin's home map, guys. So we have Topspin here playing in blue as Franks. On the other side, we have Hiten playing in red as Indians. Franks versus Indians. Oh, pretty sick matchup. Moti, do you have anything to say about these sieves?
Yeah, many people, they will think that Indians counter Franks, but I think Franks have a better chance.
Countering Indians?
Yeah.
Oh, why do you think so?
They have the better dark age bonus, that is the Vengeance bonus. Mm-hmm. And their scout rush is better with the 54 HP scout.
Oh, yes.
So I think they will get a decisive advantage in school days and then finish it in Castle.
So
then they can go, if you go a mix of knights and this thing, spiking.
Okay.
That also counters Indians pretty well.
Yeah, that is true. But looking at the map, like both the players have a decent map, but Topspin has much better map with that backward gold and those tiny two oak forests. So I think that's gonna be very easy for him to defend that area. Just like few palisade walls and few houses here and there. He can secure, I mean even that stone, look at that for Topspin is pretty good. The easily defendable base, at least from the initial raids. And for Hiten, it's not that bad either. He can also pretty much defend his base. So both the players have really good maps. And do you have anything to comment on those maps?
Yeah, usually what you want is just that your map is like ended in the corner so you can wall properly. Otherwise, you see there are some terrains like the top terrain, you cannot wall on that. So sometimes it's there at the bottom side also, so it's hard to close the map. But you definitely want to wall or at least make some walls in this map because scouts are going to be.
Yeah, real threat on this map.
Definitely a scout opening to go to this place.
So, and looking at the other gold positions, so you can see Hiten has one secondary gold pile to the left of his base. And two neutral goals exactly at the middle of the map on both the sides. And Topspin has one a secondary goal to the left of his base too. So I mean pretty evenly distributed map, right?
Sometimes players, yeah, but actually those, like, sometimes people don't find these goals.
Yeah, true. It's usually they don't scout those areas, right? And
yeah, some usually like you are used to the area, like in Arabia usually you don't have gold at the corners.
True.
You don't expand, like, you don't make PCs usually in the corner sites.
So the relics too, like three relics. Oh, actually Topspin has really good map. He can actually go and collect four relics easily. If he actually scouts and if you want to go for relics, he has that relic advantage too. Let's see, this is his home map. Is he gonna come back or not? No one knows, but let's see. Pretty sick map for Topspin with all the relics and also very easily defendable base against those scouts. So if he's gonna come back, it's gonna be pretty awesome for him. And looking at the hills, okay, there is one tiny hill here. Okay, that's gonna be a pretty good hill for Hiten. If he can actually drop a castle there, he can secure those extra piles of gold and also that stone on the left side. There is no hill, but let's see who's gonna go for that gold. And I'm not sure if anyone gonna take this gold, if Topspin gonna see this, and same for this gold too. So looking at the fog of war, Topspin has already scouted his base and he's already at Hiten's base and he is actually patrolling the gold. God knows why. Why do you think he's patrolling right next to the gold, Moti?
Maybe he's wondering if he's going for mana towns.
Ah, I see.
Sometimes people they try to go for mana towns.
So you can also see Avestan, Hiten sort of scouted his map. Oh, that forward lumber camp is also good for him. Okay, he's gonna throw some palisade walls and secure that wood line too. And
Topspin is up slightly faster.
Yeah, slightly. It's not gonna make that much of a difference, right?
Yeah,
he's gonna be all right.
But it's always nice to be like some. If you can catch the scout, then.
So we can already see Topspin has pulled up his pace pretty nicely. He's gonna be all right till castle. So he has enough wood back home, and he's up. He's going for a stable immediately as expected. So back home, Hitain. Okay, he hasn't walled up completely, but his lumber choppers are gonna be fine. He's going for a barracks. Oh, that's late. So he's gonna be slightly behind the scout numbers compared to Topspin scouts, and Topspin is pretty good with his scouts. So how much do you rate Moti Topspin's scout aggression usually?
Yeah, and the good thing for Hitain is that he already has wood on the downside, like the good wood.
True.
Whereas Topspin is still not gone.
Yep.
Gone to that spot.
Oh boy. Okay, he may not get the villager, but he might lose the scout now. That scout's gonna get wrecked now. Oh boy. That's pretty bad move by Hitain, losing that scout.
Yep.
But I mean, he's gonna be behind with the scout numbers anyway. So he's gonna be way, way behind now. Frank scouts are not joking. They're gonna be pretty sick if they can. If they get to this wood, okay, there are a couple of spears defending this wood line. This is again.
Now the important thing is that Topspin should scout that outside wood and try to pressure it.
Yeah.
Usually, people that make towers or maybe even add archery ranges.
Yeah, true.
To pressure if someone goes to the downside wood early. Let's see if Topspin can find that.
Yep.
He's actually going from the right direction, so maybe he will spot that.
Yeah. So I don't see any villager coming forward, so there won't be any towers, I guess. And
but if he scouts that is like he hasn't scouted the wood. If he scouts it, he might want to go towers.
So right now, just Topspin is sort of scouting the external area to see if he's gone outside to chop the lumber, but he finds nothing. But I mean, usually Topspin is pretty aggressive with his scouts. Right now, he's just at no man's land.
He's trying to find the wood, but he doesn't know that.
Oh, he finds a villager. He finds a villager. That lonely village is gonna get wrecked now. Oh boy.
Oh, he's even going for the spear. Nice micro.
Oh, yeah. It's just one spear, right? He's just gonna micro it down and kill the spear. Oh man, that's Topspin, guys. He's sick with his scouts. He usually goes for like 5 or 6 scouts and keep torturing you with those scouts. And he
I don't like Topspin's mining cam, bro. Topspin's cam is.
Oh, look at that. But I mean, it's fine. It's not that bad. You can just collect gold from the side piles, so at least like 3 wheels on each side is gonna be fine.
And Topspin, I think he should have gone for a lumber camp outside. But
yeah.
Sadly, he didn't scout that left side wood. That could have been the perfect place.
Oh, yes.
Make a lumber camp there, then in Castle Edge, make a TC there.
I mean, if he would have scouted that gold, maybe he would have gone for that lumber camp, but.
I think in the front, he might think that it's exposed, don't want to go there.
Difficult
and Topspin still hasn't found Hitain's wood.
True. Now he's moving forward with his scouts and few spearmen too. Let's see if he's gonna find any lonely villagers and maybe do some sort of harassment. But looking at.
He sees that wood.
And now he sees it. But Hitain has more, okay, like both the players with the equal number of scouts, but Topspin has more military, just one. But this, like coming forward with spears is good, but I mean, he needs that one tower on the wood line to harass Hitain. He's not doing that right now. The one tower would have been so good. Like denying that complete wood line and probably get even like one or two kills once he build the tower.
Like the bad thing is that Topspin's wood eco is very bad. I think he's going out now.
Yeah, he has to go out. There's no option for him to stay here in his base.
Maybe and he just wants to make like he just wants to wait till castle and just make a
town center. Or okay, look at this.
Center.
Look at this villages. They're walking like 10 miles to drop off the wood. Is this typical topspin's lumber camp, Hiten?
No.
No.
But it happens on this map, like, that is the unique feature of this map.
It looks like he
So
doesn't
I'm
want to
surprised
waste.
that Topspin didn't try to take fight there. Now Hiten is moving forward now. Hiten is going for archery range.
What? Okay, we not finished game? Why?
Yeah, why? I don't know what happened.
What happened?
So is the 2.2 the second part of this game? Let's check
Probably.
that.
Yeah, I think so. It's drop spin. So, guys, those who are just tuning into the channel, welcome everyone. We have already announced about AOE India channels. If you want to know, just type exclamation AOE India. You'll get all the links. Share love to those channels. From next Monday onwards, we'll be streaming on AOE India channels. It's gonna be a multi-platform stream, both on YouTube, Facebook, and also Twitch. So check it out, guys. So G2. 2. An awesome labeling, Hiten. Thank you. Oh yeah, I'm in the game now. Moti, are you?
Yeah, no, I'm having some issues.
Okay. Shall I pause the game then?
No, you go ahead and catch up. I'm watching the stream also.
Okay, cool. So archery range.
Ah, shit, my game crashed again.
And then load it.
Restarting again.
Okay. A lot of spears for
User
Topswin,
disconnected from your channel.
and this is. But just put so much aggression. Why not just build one tower here? That's gonna be pretty good if he builds a tower there. Complete woodline will get just denied. It will force Hiten to take his villagers back, and then he can use all of his spears to the scouts, and scouts can do actually a lot of damage here. He can actually kill at least one or two wills with his awesome Scouts micro. That's what he does usually, but I don't know why he is just sloppy here. So that's bad by Topspin. Like, looking at the village account, so 34 wills for Topspin and 33 for Hiten. Hiten just lost one villager here while building a wall to Topspin scouts. That's actually just one will difference. And the military wise, both the players are exactly the similar number. And now top Hiten is moving forward with his scouts. Let's see if he's gonna find anything here. I don't think so. And he's gonna get caught by the spears, and all the scouts are gonna get. Oh man, these scouts are pretty bad now. And good catch by Topspin there, and killing half the scouts. And where are his scouts now? He's moving forward with the villagers. Looks like he's gonna go to this lumber camp and maybe build a town center there. So he's gonna defend with these spears for now. And let's see, the Frank Knights are gonna come out. Oh, why is he moving out again? Okay, there you go. There's a castle there, and the scouts are doing nothing again. Man, this is bad. Oh, without these spears, all those wills, at least like a couple of wills would have got wrecked there. But what is the play? Cavalry archers by Hiten? Oh boy. Cavalry archers versus knights? Frank knights? If Hiten wins this game, that's gonna be pretty awesome. Cavalry archers versus Frank knights? Oh boy. See what's gonna happen. So, Pike. So sort of Hiten is expecting there will be a lot of camels and just camels to counter against those knights, but looks like Topswain is sort of preparing for that. I think he sees these two archery ranges. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, he sees that, but still, this is interesting. This is really interesting play by Topswain. So he has made another town center back home. But he doesn't have to defend at all. He could have actually gone here and make the town center. That would have been much more worthy town center than this one here. So now let's see. Okay, Hiten is moving forward with his cavalry archers. This town center. Town center built inside a palisade. Inside the palisade walls. So this is a tiny arena, guys, for Hiten. So yeah, this one makes sense. I mean, I'm not a big fan of this one too, but there's no crossbows, nothing, so he could have just gone with one mining camp, and the town center here would have been pretty good and secure this area. So let's see what these CA are gonna do. So they're the military-wise, both the players are exactly at the same number of military. Then moving forward with cavalry archers, and Topsvein is moving forward with his knights. And they both cannot enter into the main bases, but Hithane can actually harass Topsvein villagers here with his cavalry archers and then run back again and again. So that's gonna be pretty good for him. The CA are gonna be good for raiding. He's just camping there. Okay, he's now heading back home with all of his military. Okay, then what is this? Looks like he's sort of confused. He doesn't know where to go. Okay. Hello, wake up. Hithane, wake up. Okay, nope. There are so many wills here. 8 wills here. He just goes here and then he stands here and then attacks the house where he could have actually killed at least 2 or 3 wills here. Oh man, this is okay. Okay, dude. Okay, now finally a couple of wills at least. That's actually good damage. So these CA are gonna be pretty good at raiding. Topsvein has to defend back home. He's sending all of his knights back. Oh, is he gonna catch? Oh nope. Okay, the CA are gonna run back. Gonna be fine. Oh shit! This is bad. He's running into the town center. Oh no. He may lose one, but yeah. Look at the health on those cavalry archers now. It's not looking so great. But military-wise, 18 for Hithane and sorry, Topsvein, and 20 for Hithane. So more and more cavalry archers are being added into the composition. Just cavalry archers. He's not doing anything else. But back home, a lot of spears. The pikemen for Topsvein. And look at this. I like this by Hithane. He just put like a couple of scouts here just to make sure. If Topspin comes to that goal, he knows it. Looking at the fog of war, Hithane still did not scout this area, so that means he doesn't know about that goal. Then that he scouted all the area, and this is he can't find his own goal, but he can see the rest of the map. Oh, how sick is that? Oh, he has to be careful here of over chopping. Hey. You can just add these villages to the stone. It's a town center here. Gonna be alright. He can chop wood there. Just two town centers for Hithane and Topsvein are three town centers. And will lead. Topsvein is actually leading the wills by 6. More and more military being added for Hithane. Like more and more cavalry archers and few camels just to tank. Or maybe create some sort of diversion for those knights going forward. And let's see if he's okay. And that knight will run away. He's gonna be alright. And the spears are gonna get wrecked to the CM, man. This is bad. Finally, the palisade arena is gone and is completely exposed here. Come on, Topsvein, what the hell? Get to the wood line, bro. You may lose few wheels here, but I mean, sloppy. Like Topsvein, I have to say that if it would have gone to the wood line, he could have killed at least 3 wheels easily, 3 to 4 wheels. But now he's taking a lot of town center fire. Then has three town centers. Oh shit, yes. Then has three town centers. Sorry. Oh my bad. He's going for the fourth one now. Finally scouted this area. Now he can see that goal too. There's two extra bows as well. Four town centers for Hithane and three for Topsvein. And the will lead still Hiten is little behind, but he's gonna be all right. But here army composition, Hiten has much better army composition. Even Topspin is going is gone for the fourth town center. I think he should have gone for Frank castles instead of that extra town centers. Siege workshop for Hiten. Looks like he's gonna click up to Imperial as well. Topspin already on the way to Imperial Age. He's advancing to Imperial much faster than Hiten. So, what's his army composition is gonna be? Looks like he's gonna stick with the knights. Probably he's gonna go for paladin. He's not making anything else. How is he gonna counter a ton of cavalry archers? Even if he gets paladin, let's say if Hiten gets to enough numbers, ballistics and all the upgrades, these cavalry archers are gonna be pretty sick. Just has to find a choke point and then all the paladins are gonna get wrecked. But Frank paladins are no joke, but Topspin need those numbers. Look at the military composition, just 12 military for Topspin and 34 for Hiten. Hiten is slightly behind by worlds, but looking at his army or composition, I think he is alright, and also he can easily catch up with that eco and also get more wills than Topspin. Okay, more archery ranges for Thane and stables. Okay, more stables for Topspin. Looks like he's just struggling to get up his numbers. At least by now he should have queued up so many knights. Look, let's have a quick look at his resources. He has enough resources to spam, but looks like he's prioritizing the cavalier upgrade more than the army numbers. So he's dropping more and more stables. Okay, he just reached Imperial Age, and the cavalier upgrade and more armor. Hey Kaka, welcome to the stream. I don't know you. You ask yourself. Okay, looks like Topspin is gonna go for a raid and he's gonna get caught with the archer, cavalry archers. Oh boy. The defensive castle there by Hiten is gonna be pretty good. So that means his eco is gonna be pretty happy there. It's not gonna get harassed anytime soon. And okay, this army composition is gonna be pretty sick. Camels and cavalry archers. So there's no way I see Topspin is gonna kill this composition. Oh, he's again running through. See, okay, he just got the cavalier upgrade. Look at this choke. All the cavalier is gonna get wrecked. This is pretty bad engagement for Topspin. He might lose all of his army again. So look at numbers. It's going down pretty fast for him. He's coming forward with the mangonels. Can he get a shot? Oh yes! But still, no bada boom. Oh man. This is bad. Hiten is just gonna add more and more camels here. Four stables, nice micro there. That shot would have killed at least 3 to 4 cavalry archers. Look at the military composition now, like pretty sick for Hiten. And back home, still more cavalier. Just cavalier. No paladin. Okay, finally Topspin has decided to go for skirms. Getting the upgrades. Okay, he has 2 archery ranges, but can he match up with Hiten's composition and the military numbers? That I don't think so. Skirms are gonna get wrecked to the camels, and cavalier are gonna get wrecked to CA and camels. So Hiten at pretty good position. Topspin is just trying to raid him and in multiple directions and create some sort of diversion for Topspin so that for Hiten. He's killing a lot of wills. It's actually good. Topspin is at 111 wills and all these raids are actually helping him even much better. But the composition is something that not looking so great for Topspin if the game goes late. Riten is coming back. Oh, more. Oh man, this is gonna be bad. So more camels, more. Oh boy, this is just bad fight. Why are you fighting this top spin? Just run away. And also the raids here. Top spin is pretty good with his heavily with his stable units, guys, usually. But here, and he's just throwing all the cavalier for nothing. Kuni's gonna throw off that mangonel too. Oh boy. Oh, I don't see a way back for Topspin. He's gonna lose more and more army. At least he is raiding at several places and bringing those will numbers down. That's not gonna hurt. He can just make more and more. Military, it's gonna be all right with that. So looking at the resources for Hithane, he is sort of struggling. So the raids are sort of working, but again, military numbers, somehow Topspin managed to get up the numbers, but let's see, can he push? So where's the military now for, okay. Okay, now Hithane is moving forward with his camels. Looks like he's gonna go and raid. And he's coming back with all of his cavalry archers. And still no heavy cavalry archer. Let's see if Topspin is at really good position now with all his military composition. He has enough number of skirms, enough number of cavalier. But leaving skirms alone without any... Oh, protection is gonna be bad. Just 5 to 7, probably around 10 camels can kill all this. And also Topspin may lose all of his... Oh man, this, look at this pretty good castle by Hithane, and all the cavalry are just running through the castle. And yeah, he's gonna just send his cavalry archer army and then clear of that. And raiding some places with the cavalry archers. Okay, looking at the will numbers, Hithane is slowly getting up with those wills. And let's see. Okay, he's gonna lose more wills. Oh boy. And oh shit. Sneaky stables, guys. And yeah, a lot of raid going here at Topspin's eco. He's gonna lose a lot of economy if he doesn't respond to this. Looks like he's not... Okay, finally he looked at it. So those few light cavalry are gonna get wrecked. That's fine. Still cavalry archers. Not heavy cavalry archer. And now Halt's being added by Topspin. So he has all the units right now in the mix. But can he... stabilize and push Hithane back? That's the question here. So what do you guys think? So the sneaky stables here, so he's gonna just throw like more and more light cavalry into Topspin's economy, which he doesn't have any here. But this game can go in either direction, guys. Oh. And bombard cannons too. Oh man. Where is he going? With all his military. Oh no. Looks like he's gonna go around and push this area because there is gold here. He wants to trap down the castle. But I mean, that's good move, but then again its complete area will be open for the raids. And again, yeah, a few camels getting into the base, and there are a few halves there to defend. So, if Topspin can get actually good amount of halbs and skirms here, he's gonna defend this area pretty easily and even get the castle down and push forward. But look at this, Hithane is just creating more and more devotion by the raids. Oh, it's a big fight now, let's see. Oh man, this is... Why? Where river halts? Oh bad, this is bad. All the skirms are gonna get wrecked. Even the cavalry are gonna get wrecked because of the heavy camels there. and all the hearts are melting to the CA. Oh man, the military numbers, Topspin has more and more numbers, it's just trash. He has few cavalier and lot of trash. Oh boy. Why is... Oh, now look. Oh boy, Imperial camels. So yeah, this is gonna be pretty bad for Topspin. Let's see how his micro is gonna be here. Okay, he's doing that AI micro. Oh man, no. Oh no. So that's it, guys. Topspin's army is gone now. He's running back with the scums. He is using halbs to kill Imperial camels. But look at all these sneaky.
Namaste.
One brave villager mining that gold. Awesome. I don't know why Topspin is not collecting that gold. See if he can see that gold actually or not. He sees it just one tile. Maybe he did not pay enough attention to that. But other than that, what happened to the military here? Just turned away for a second and then like all the military is gone. So still Topspin is being able to reduce, but mobility is something that he doesn't have. The Imperial camels are moving into the economy again. Oh, this is a good trap. Yeah. Or maybe not. Oh shit, man. Hey Kaka, please organize some 1v1 show matches. Oh yeah, sure, why not? Which ones do you want? Let me know. Oh boy. And all the scouts and halves, Imperial camels are gonna get wrecked again. But looking at the resources, look at this. Ethane is just floating with resources. And look at the raids, man. Oh boy. Those sneaky stables are doing a lot of work for him. He's everywhere on the map. He's defending back home. Oh, he has lost all of his cavalry archers. The same day Topspin is gonna lose all of his halves to the castle. And Hiten is collecting relics too. Ifer, you want more show matches? Yes, find an opponent. And Topspin is actually struggling. Oh, he's just making more and more trash. But Indians can counter all the trash. And also Hiten has shitload of gold. He's even mining Topspin's gold right there. And looking at the wells now, look at that. Hiten at 110 wells and Topspin at 107, pretty even for both the players. But the military, 70 for Topspin, but he's not being able to push at all. I'm your opponent. Oh yeah, good luck. I can do that. Topspin versus Foodie, that would be amazing, right? But Foodie doesn't play, I think. If he agrees, I don't mind organizing that. Oh, Topspin, find this gold. Yeah, I've scouted this. Just go and find this. Oh man. Pretty bad. The military numbers, still Topspin is leading way ahead with the military, and now Hiten is adding a lot of hussars. Oh boy, this is bad. And the bomber cannons too. So both the players are at really good position, and more military buildings being added by Topspin, by Hiten. TG show matches. Yeah, maybe we can do that too. How about next Monday? So that's when we are starting our AOE India live channels. Maybe a show match on Monday would be pretty cool. Look at that army melt. Oh boy. and the constant protection. Now looking at the military, somehow Hiten, not somehow, he just managed to get up his military numbers up, and yeah, just few alps just roaming around. Still, this is bad. And Topspin says yes, and GG. Oh. And pretty sick fight here. I mean, it's definitely the Indian eco finally came into play, and the military composition for Hiten was much better, and the micro was much better. He was just raiding everywhere with those hussars, and he had those three stables always spamming into Topspin's main eco. Brackets. I have no idea why it's not working at Xe. I think it should pop soon. Or maybe just try brackets. It may work. And the final will count. Hiten with 123. And the economy. Topspin had more food, stone collected, but didn't see a lot of cash. It looks like he sold a lot of resources. But look at that, the 311 units killed, lost 214. Blue Wolf versus Srini Mama. Blue Wolf might not play for some time now, he is quite busy. Onkar versus for a Link. Link and Onkar would be pretty difficult to organize because Link lives in States. Onkar versus for. I don't think that's really good matchup. He hasn't. Has three. Has the three wolf. So let's go to. Let me update the scores quickly. That's 2-0 for. In, and. If Topspin wants to stay alive, he should win this game, or else he's out of the tournament. Let's go G21 now. Moti, you here? It looks like Moti is not here, so I'm gonna cast the games. So this is game number 3, guys. African Waters, pretty sick map. So we're gonna do this in. Speed? No. So we have Italians for Topspin, and for Hiten we have Japanese. Japanese versus Italians. So if you guys are not aware of these maps, these are BOA2 maps, and we have lakes at the corners on BOA2 water, African waters, and the middle area here is completely visible, guys. So everyone can see, both the players can see the town centers. Easy to get lamed because there are a lot of elephants right next to the town center. You just have to get loom and then sneak a villager around and then we try to get that one elephant. Hey Kaka, see ya. Thanks man for dropping by. Check out AOE India channel, Kaka, if you have time. So. This is pretty aggressive map, guys. It's completely exposed. You just cannot wall off this area. Let's see what Topspin is gonna do here with Italians. So looking at the scouting, yeah, I mean they can see everything in the middle. So the main task is to find the wood lines and the gold, and then try to harass those areas. With Japanese, I'm expecting sort of men-at-arms. Oh, okay, yeah, I see that already. So Hiten is gonna go for men-at-arms to archers. And he's already. Okay, both the players have clicked up. Topspin advancing to feudal faster. But Italians. Nice. Let's see what he's gonna do. He has military already out.
impressed.
Looks like he's gonna go archers too, but Japanese men-at-arms are gonna be pretty good. Much better than Italians. So let's see. Topspin, can he see this? Oh yeah, he sees that. Oh, nice quick walling by Hiten there. He sees that and he immediately quick walls everything, even the wood line and the berries too. And men-at-arms still nope. He's just waiting for the men-at-arm upgrade. And he has his Topspin has his scout and he's going for archery range. The other side, okay, even Topspin is going for archery range. He has archery range already outside. He's moving forward with the archers. Looks like he's gonna group up with the men-at-arms and go back. Okay, double archery range for Hiten. Oh man. What? That was just sick micro. What the hell just happened? Hiten killed everything there. Couple of archers, all the men-at-arms, everything. Seems like Topspin is just struggling with his micro now. And the blacksmith. And he says 11 GG. Yeah, it looks GG already. But let's see if he's gonna say GG or if he's gonna play. I mean, he can actually get back into the game. He doesn't have a secondary archery range. Still on one archery range. Gonna be bad for him. But he has some sort of archers and few skirms here. But let's see. Fletching for both the players. And Hiten might lose few wheels here. No, he decided to use the wheels and fight. And he still did not lose a single village. Okay, he's gonna lose now. Maybe now. Nope, he's not losing a single villager to these many archers. Nice, amazing micro there. What the hell? What the hell, man? That's sick micro there. I'm pretty surprised to see that. Not losing a single villager to like half a dozen archers with fletching. And he's sending a one villager to dock this area, so that's gonna boost up his economy. Then he's just camping this area, like he's just waiting. And Topspin is just coming and throwing his army every time. And look at the military now, a 12 military for Hiten and Topspin calls GG. Oh yeah, villages are military. Yes, Death by Radish. Villages are military indeed. So that's 3-0 guys, that brings series to end. So Hiten advances to the final, and now we have to see the next semi-finals, which is gonna be between Mystigan versus Cynical Link. So both the players are again friends. Yep. Both play from USA. They're living in USA, studying, and one working. So before that, just give me a minute to update the scores and everything, guys. So all right, back. So we'll go through the ad for a minute, then start up the